In this third OEE training video, we get to the whole reason for doing this in the first place, and that is to analyze the data so that we can make adjustments and improve processes. So let's go back to our help worksheet and scroll down to where we left off, where it tells us that we're now ready to import data from our WorkCenter log worksheets. And remember that we might have multiple WorkCenter log worksheets, each of which might be in a separate workbook, all feeding a single OEE data worksheet. So if we go to our OEE data worksheet and scroll over, where we see that these same instructions are repeated in this text box right above the import from daily log button. It tells us to, in the log worksheet, we're going to select the A all data from the name box and then use auto filter to filter for the desired date range. So rather than using the log worksheet, let's just use existing sample data in the sample worksheet. So let's do it. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to select the name box up here in the upper left corner. Then we're going to select the very first item in this drop-down list called the A all data item. That's just going to make sure that we've got the right table list selected when we do auto filter, which we will do next. We're going to select data, filter. And that will cause all these little filter drop-down arrows to appear in each of the column headers. And we're going to select the one for date, and then we will deselect everything but the date or dates that we want to import. Notice that the little filter symbol indicates that this column is now being filtered. And now back on the OEE worksheet, we go back to our instructions, and our next step is to click the button to import from a daily log, which might be in the same workbook or it might be in a different workbook. And then notice that it reminds us to triple verify that we have indeed filtered that log worksheet before importing and going any further. And then from this window, it'll show us the choice of valid worksheets within our selected workbook that are log worksheets. If you had multiple logs in one workbook, they'd all be here to choose from. We're just going to use the sample data for demonstration purposes. And that will import your data. And up will come this window to remind you to triple check your data to make sure you haven't imported any duplicate data. If you have, you just delete those rows or close the workbook and reopen it if you hadn't saved it. And there you go. That's how you import data. If you had multiple log worksheets feeding one OEE data worksheet, you would repeat the process as many times as needed. And with that, you now have two sources of data that you can analyze. You have the OEE data worksheet that contains the summary data from perhaps several different log worksheets. And then each log worksheet has more detailed data that can be analyzed in ways that the OEE summary data cannot. So if we scroll over to the right on any log worksheet, we will find this instruction box for how to use this button to generate a filtered log worksheet, where you will find your data for Pareto analysis and unlimited user-defined charts and analyses using everything that you know about Excel. And similarly, on the OEE data worksheet, if we scroll over to the right, we will find this text box containing instructions for how to use this button to generate a filtered worksheet based upon our summary OEE data. Using either of those buttons, you'll be asked to enter a human-readable description of how you filtered your data. And that description will appear in this field up in the header of the generated filtered worksheet. And as you scroll down, you'll find many predefined charts that'll be familiar to anybody who's done anything with OEE before and might become your favorite charts if you've never been exposed to them before. The waterfall chart is particularly popular, and people love the fact that if you scroll over, you can instantly generate a waterfall chart for any row. of your data that you can filter any way that you want to. And another feature you'll grow to love is this And On button. When you click it, any data that is outside of your user-defined And On tolerance ranges will turn pink or yellow if it's halfway close to your user-defined tolerance level. And with that, you should have the training that you need to use your powerful new tool to identify problems and opportunities to improve your overall equipment effectiveness. And that's as far as any of our competitors are going to take you. You identify your problems. The big difference with Systems to Win is that we provide an entire suite of Excel and Word templates to help you actually solve the problems once you've identified them and actually improve your processes. Welcome to Systems to Win.